from the historic Loretto Abbey Chapel. With the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. I'm Father Hank Van Myle. The televising of this Mass is made possible by the contribution from the Sisters of St. Martha of Prince Edward Island from Charlottetown. This Mass is offered in gratitude to God for the graces and blessings bestowed upon the Sisters of St. Martha of Prince Edward Island during their 105-year history. For the benefactors and friends of the sisters, and to ask God's blessings on their administration. Or thanks to the Sisters of St. Martha of Prince Edward Island for the gift of the televising of this Mass to the faithful of Canada and around the world. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you. And as we have placed ourselves before the Lord, just like St. Martha did in the time of Jesus, knowing that she was weak, knowing that all wisdom and goodness comes from God. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, whose Son was pleased to be welcomed in St. Martha's house as a guest, grant, we pray, that through her intercession, serving Christ faithfully in our brothers and sisters, we may merit to be received by you in the halls of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Moses did everything just as the Lord had commanded him. In the first month, in the second year, on the first day of the month, the tabernacle was set up. Moses set up the tabernacle. He laid its bases and set up its frames and put in its poles and raised up its pillars. And he spread the tent over the tabernacle and put the covering of the tent over it as the Lord had commanded Moses. He took the covenant and put it into the ark and put the poles on the ark and set the mercy seat above the ark. And he brought the ark into the tabernacle and set up the curtain for screening and screened the ark of the covenant as the Lord had commanded Moses. Then the cloud covered the tent of meeting and the glory of the Lord filled the tabernacle. Moses was not able to enter the tent of meeting because the cloud settled upon it and the glory of the Lord filled the tabernacle. Whenever the cloud was taken up from the tabernacle, the Israelites would set out on each stage of their journey. But if the cloud was not taken up, then they did not set out until the day that it was taken up. For the cloud of the Lord was on the tabernacle by day, and fire was in the cloud by night. Before the eyes of all the house of Israel at each stage of their journey, the word of the Lord.
To the living God.
not your altars, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God. How lovely is your dwelling place, Lord mighty God. Happy are those who live in your house, ever singing your praise. Happy are those whose strength is in you. They go from strength to strength. How lovely is your dwelling place, Lord mighty God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus arrived and found Lazarus had already been in the tomb 4 days, now Bethany was near Jerusalem, some 2 miles away, and many Jews had come to Martha and Mary to console them about their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went and met him, while Mary stayed at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that God will give you whatever you ask of him." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." Martha said to him, "I know that he will rise again in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live, and everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one coming into the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We have a profound act of faith of Martha in today's Gospel reading. And she goes almost from the worldly, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would have been saved," to saying that it doesn't matter anymore. Whatever you ask, it's okay. I trust that you are the Son of God, that you are the Messiah, that all good comes through you, no matter what happens on the outside in a worldly affair. And when we go to to Exodus, our first reading, it's actually a very symbolic reading, how the Israelites set up the tabernacle and they put the Ten Commandments in it, and a cloud of God sits over it. Cloud of God sits over it. Even Moses couldn't get in, or should not come in. And when the cloud rises, then the Israelites move. It's very symbolic also for our lives. We often forget that each one of us actually is a tabernacle of God too. We are tabernacles, but it takes a lifetime to come to that understanding, or probably beyond, that we're tabernacles of God, and that we have to more and more listen to that Spirit, that God moves us forward, when it is time that we know that we have to move forward, and God will put things in place for us, that we don't have to work too hard. Often in my life, in my own life journey, I learned that if there's still too much confusion or there's still no consensus, it's time not to take a decision. We have to wait for God. And when somehow things fall in place, there will be a certain peace around it. And if that is around a material thing, say moving a house, or something what is more personal, say an illness, cancer, or whatever it is, there is that time that we realize that we are in God's hands. God, you lead. Show us the way. I accept. And this is really what Martha is saying in our gospel reading. She was a woman of faith, absolutely, but she verbalizes it profoundly. And in our gospel reading, Mary stayed at home. Interesting. Martha is the doer. She's the matriarch, and apparently Martha in Aramaic, actually, if you go back to the, it means actually mistress, the one who takes care of things. But Mary is the other one staying at home, probably in silent prayer. And in our own lives, it is bringing the two together. We in community, we need leaders, we need people who do things, and of course, we have the more contemplative personalities. But we come together, but we're all tabernacles of God. And so even when we look across our faith, you have, say, someone who has a busy life, a woman, say a mother with several children, if she's spending all day in church, there's something wrong. But she's still a tabernacle. But there's other people in our faith, in say in monastic communities, who do have that time to pray. Myself as a priest, I'm very busy, but because I do not have to take care of a family, there's all kinds of extra time to pray, to meditate on scripture, to meditate on the suffering of other people, and so on. So we each have a different calling, but we each are called really to work and pray in various ways. And so if I take a mother with three children, she, of course, is called to pray too. But the labor part is more essential, especially when children are young. But there has to be that prayer. And prayer actually is something we live. It's not something we do, oh, it's time to pray. No, it's something we live. And so to bring the two together, in Benedictine spirituality or in the rule of Saint Benedict, we talk about ora et labora, pray and work. In Ignatian spirituality, we talk about contemplation in action. Come out of the silence, and out of that silence, we work. And that can take so many different forms. But really, Martha and Mary are those archetypes. It's interesting that we don't see anything or read anything more about Lazarus. Lazarus, who was raised from the dead by Jesus. I wonder how Lazarus felt about that, because if I were to be raised from the dead as a living physical person, I know I have to die again too. How would Lazarus have felt about that? Lazarus, of course, also a person of faith. Very much so. But so often we also I hear prayers, oh God, save me, save me, save me, and physically save me. But is that spiritually the best for us? If I had cancer, and I can get cancer just like anyone else, and I have a life journey ahead too, what we don't know what that will look like. But It is God's. It is God's. But if I were to die, and even if I had an illness or a painful illness, I would offer it up to God. But if I would be raised again, I would have to die again. What would that look like? It is for us to really good stuff to pray with. And it's all about more and more realizing that we're tabernacles of God, that we have to live clean lives, and to be people for others. But in the end, it is not about us, about myself. It is about us as a people on the journey to God. Amen. And so let us bring our prayers before the Lord. We pray for all those in the Daily TV Mass community who have asked to pray for young people that our Blessed Mother and Saint Joseph will guide them to a deeper relationship with Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With Pope Francis, we pray that in social, economic, and political situations of conflict, we may be courageous and passionate architects of dialogue and friendship. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all women who, like Saint Martha and Saint Mary, desire to be examples of God's love for others in daily life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in thanksgiving for the work of the Sisters of Saint Martha of Prince Edward Island and for young women to consider a vocation to vowed religious life with the desire of being signs of God's love in an ever-changing world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for these prayers and the prayers in the silence of our own hearts, we lift them up to you, Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities. Cleanse me of my sins. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we proclaim your wonders in Saint Martha, O Lord, we humbly implore your majesty that as her homage of love was pleasing to you, so too our dutiful service may find favor in your sight, through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are praised in the company of your saints, and in crowning their merits, you crown your own gifts. By their way of life, you offer us an example. By communion with them, you give us companionship. By their intercession, sure support, so that encouraged by so great a cloud of witnesses, we may run as victors in the race before us and win with them the imperishable crown of glory through Christ our Lord. And so, with the angels and archangels, and with the great multitude of saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Hosanna in the
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these guests, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, the order of bishops, the clergy, and the entire people you have called your own. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that I should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And may the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. For eternal life.
Please join me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart, as though you were already there. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Permit not that I should ever be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. May the holy reception of the body and blood of your only begotten Son, O Lord, turn us away from the cares of this fallen world, so that following the example of Saint Martha, we may grow in sincere love for you on earth and rejoice to behold you for eternity in heaven. Through Christ, O Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass.
Lifted on the glory.